Hello everyone and welcome back to another Marvel Crisis Protocol Battle Report. And today we have for you an Asgardian themed team versus Avengers themed team with some new miniatures on the table as well. New table setup, it's all ready to go. So we're going to jump straight in and take a look at the crews in a second. But first, just a reminder, please do remember to subscribe if you want to see more in the future. Both battle reports for Crisis Protocol as well as unboxings of new characters. And also coverage of the other games we play here. And if you want to show above and beyond support, consider checking out the Patreon, which does help keep the lights on, and also support the video gaming stream that I do 6 nights a week. Anyway, with that, let's take a look at the teams. So here are our Avengers for you today. We have Captain America, we have Iron Man, we have Black Panther, and then the two new additions, Vision, who is just an Avenger by default, and then Winter Soldier, who for affiliation purposes counts as whatever you need them to be. So all Avengers affiliated, technically. And their tactics cards are Avengers Assemble, Ricochet Blast, Field Dressing, which is new from the Vision Winter Soldier box, so is the End of the Line, and also Second Wind. So 5 minis on their squad, 4 on the other, but at least it's got a theme. So this is a Thor Ragnarok themed team here. Will it end up being good? Who knows? It's just a fun theme. So we have Thor, we have Valkyrie, we have Loki, and we have the Hulk. And the tactics cards on play here are Sibling Rivalry, Patch Up, Doomed Prophecy, Seeing Red, and Odin's Blessing. So they're one miniature down in terms of totals, but Asgardian is affiliation, and they are rearing to go. Might end up being a bad mix-up, but we'll see. So the two missions being played for you today are Gamma Wave Sweep Across the Midwest and also Fear Grips the World as Worthy Terrorize Citizens. It's this threat value that's being played, not the 15 obviously because of the miniatures. So this is the one where there's a 3 Gamma Shelter to get points for securing... That's the dog scratching herself if you can hear that. Securing, and you get more points for the ones that are further away from where you started. And this is the Worthy Hammers lying around, pick them up and you get one extra attack. But the cost of tactics cards goes up by 1 as well. So, the hammers are there, 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 and the gamma shelters are right across the middle. Thanks to Hulk's massive base size and only having to be within 3, he can be very, very close to 1. It will be... Oh, and also there's Thor hidden there. It will be the Avengers going first. That's how they're lined up. As we go into Battle Round 1. So to get the game started, the Vision activated, and he moves medium, so he moved up, he spent a power to pick up the Hammer of the Worthy that were there, and he's still within the capture distance of this closest shower. He used his other action to use his zero cost superpower called Synthesis, which just generates him 2 power, so all said and done he has 2 power on him because he spent 1 to pick up the Hammer, and he's just going to stay there. So now it's over to the Asgardians. So as you might expect, Thor was the first activation for the Asgardians, and he swooped in with 2 move actions to snatch the hammer that was there, because obviously Black Panther was positioned to just go nab it, or Iron Man to back him up. It does open him up to potentially some fire on turn 1. He's also not in a gamma shelter, so he's going to take damage at the end of the turn regardless. But it was probably worth it to snatch one of those hammers nice and early, especially because the one at the far end of the table is actually just kind of being ignored currently. So Steve Rogers activated next, and he also has just done 2 movement actions, double medium move into the central gamma shelter to force some action from the angry gentleman over there, probably, or maybe the Asgardians there as well. We shall see, but Hulk is obviously very difficult to deal with unless you can blitz him down, and that might be an issue. So the angriest gentleman activated. He moved small first, then spent a power to pick up the hammer that was there. Then for his second action, moved small again into the middle. Then he spent his remaining 2 power, because remember Hulk generates 3 in total in his turn, or in the power phase for his turn. Asgardians get 2. He picked up Captain America and just chucked him medium into that rock there for 1 damage, and obviously taking him away from the central shelter, so he's not safe, so he's going to take damage, and he's not contesting it either, which is quite annoying. Iron Man moved up medium and hoped to be able to reach with range 4 to Repulsor Blast Hulk to push him a little bit. Oh, actually, he's probably too big to be pushed. I don't remember if there's a stipulation for it, but it doesn't matter because he was out of range, so he just moved twice, slightly forward of the shelter, and isn't doing anything else. And with that, back over to either Loki or Valkyrie. Valkyrie activated and did a double medium move for her turn, which got her close enough to spend 1 of her 2 power on picking up the Worthy Hammer that landed over here, meaning that that's now all the Worthy Hammers in possession of people. The Avengers only have 1, the Asgardians have 3, which is kind of nasty. So, it's over to either Bucky or T'Challa now. So Bucky moved up to the safety of the closest shelter there, and he used his range 5 assault rifle on the Hulk. It's only 4 attack dice against 2 defense dice for Hulk, but bad roll, so no damage there. The bullets just bounced off his gamma-infused skin. So now it's Loki to end the turn for the Asgardians, and then Black Panther for the Avengers. So we can just quickly cover those last 2 activations because there were just movement. So Loki had to just put himself to the closest shelter just so that would be captured, plus he's safe. And then T'Challa moved up long and is right in the middle to contest the middle shelter against the Hulk there, but double move, so he didn't get the chance to attack. And that takes us to the cleanup phase for Battle Round 1. So at the end of Battle Round 1, it will be the Asgardians going first when we go into Battle Round 2. But in terms of victory points, the Avengers scored their closest shelter for 1, the middle one is contested, and the Asgardians scored their closest one for 1. The Asgardians have 3 of the hammers for 3 victory points, and the Avengers have 1. So the Asgardians are leading 4-2, and everybody not within 2 of a shelter takes 1 damage. So Captain America, Valkyrie, and Thor have all taken 1 damage that does not generate any power for them, and now we're into Battle Round 2 proper. So after a little bit of umming and eyeing, Hulk went first, and he did 2 strikes on Black Panther and then spent 2 power on chucking him via whatever Hulk's throw is called. So the first actually whiffed kind of badly despite the extra hammer dice being thrown in, did 1 damage. Second one did much better, did 3, and then when he was thrown at Captain America, he took 1. Captain America successfully evaded though and took no damage from that. Black Panther is hurting though, I believe he has 1 HP left on his healthy side, he's sitting on a lot of power now. But he also got thrown away from the shelter. That said, it's over to the Avengers for their first activation. So Black Panther decided to try and get some payback. So first of all, he did a pounce. Normally it would cost 2, but thanks to a day unlike any other, it cost 1 to just bounce back in front of the Hulk. Then he spent 2 on, what is it called again? I've forgotten. The Mantle of the Black Panther for 2, which lets him re-roll failed attack dice. Then he did a kinetic burst, putting in 1 extra power for an extra attack dice. Rolled horribly, and that includes the reroll, and it would have been a great roll on his defense rolls against the Hulk because of so many blanks, because his vibranium armor protects him on blanks as well. But that said, Hulk got 1 damage, and it does specify as long as you get a wild, you push people away small, and it doesn't say there's a size limit, so despite the Hulk being so big, it does seem like he also gets pushed back by the kinetic burst, so he's been shoved back onto the shelter over there. 1 whole damage. That was like 8 power, no, not 8, 6 power. 6 power spent, 1 damage received. So the next activation for the Asgardians was Valkyrie. She moved up medium and then spent 2 on a charge, which is another medium move followed by a basic strike. Now, totally forgot that Vision is supposed to declare at the start of each of his turns whether he is in solid state or whatever the other one is called. Basically, is he defending better against physical or energy? Totally forgot to declare. Flipped the coin for it, he did get physical, so he did get his bonus dice, but it doesn't matter because his defense dice did not go his way. He took 3 damage from Valkyrie's charge and is injured, and she is within 2, I believe, of that shelter, so she's now contesting it. She charged right in there. So Vision activated and he had a good turn there. He used Synthezoid Avenger, or whatever it's called. Yep, Synthezoid Avenger, 7 physical attack, although 8 because he had a hammer, and it means that the opponent does not get to count crits as successes and they don't generate additional dice, which is pretty amazing. So he unleashed them upon Valkyrie, did 5 damage, which was enough to stun her, so she dropped her hammer. Oh, actually, I just realised the hammer should still be on the ground because Vision moved up and played Second Wind, which would be not enough power to pick up the hammer as well, so the hammer will get put down next to Iron Man probably because he'll pick it up. The Second Wind was played. Vision and Black Panther both count in the Avengers affiliation card, however Black Panther has no power to play this, but Vision and Captain America both spent 1 power to heal 1 damage. And then he moved where you can see him, next to the middle there. Thor activated next, and perhaps he was a little bit miffed about what happened to Valkyrie, so he flew over the truck with 1 medium move, still within 2 of it, just barely. He did the Strongest Avenger to pick up the truck and throw it at Vision. It only did 2 damage, all said and done, and then he still had 1 action left because the superpower was the throw, or the throw was the superpower rather, so he just did a basic strike because Vision was within 2 of him, because it was basically, he was smack dab there, he was within 2 of Vision and 2 of the truck, which was perfect range. So then he just smacked Vision, got a wild so he could push, or rather he could throw Vision over there, and it did one additional damage from the impact of the throw. So 3 damage done to Vision plus a 2 on him. He is lucky he healed via patch-up, otherwise he would have been dazed. So Iron Man activated next, but first of all, Star's cameo. You don't care. So Iron Man moved up medium to where you can see him. Oh, first of all, sorry, he spent a power to pick up the hammer that Valkyrie dropped. Where he was, he did a repulsor blast on Thor, did no damage, but before damage is dealt, thanks to a wild, he pushed Thor away small, so Thor has been pushed over there and is not safe. He wasn't before anyway, but definitely not safe now. And with that, it's over to Loki to end the turn for the Asgardians, and then Captain America and Bucky get to go. So Loki opted to stay where he was to secure the back shelter here with the Hulk, but he was still able to reach, so he spent 3 power on illusions on Iron Man. It did good damage, it did 2, well, it did 3 damage but got reduced to 2 because of Invincible Iron Man. It did not get the 2 wilds required that would have let him move Iron Man small, which would have been real bad because he would have been moved there, and then he does a free 1 damage attack on everyone within 2, so that would have been nasty. So good job it needed 2 wilds. So with that, it's just straight over to Bucky and Captain America. They get to just do whatever they want. Does also mean that it will still be the Asgardians going first next turn, though. So for the final 2 activations of the second battle round, Bucky just repositioned slightly, couldn't see Thor over the rock there to shoot him, just out of 5 anyway, so did nothing, just camping, waiting for Valkyrie to wake up. Captain America moved medium to where you can see him, then threw his shield at Loki, did amazingly well with his roll against Loki, did 4 damage and a ricochet, so bounced into Hulk's head just for the 1 damage, and has put 2 total damage on him, I think, which is ideal actually, because it's every 3 damage that he gets an extra dice thrown in. So that takes us to the cleanup phase for this battle round. So as things stand at the end of battle round 2, Thor is the only one not within 2 of a shelter, so he has taken 1 damage. Valkyrie is obviously flipping her card over. In terms of victory points gained, the Avengers hold their closest shelter for 1, they hold the middle for 2. The Asgardians hold their closest shelter for 1. A little bit of shifting in the hammers, however. The Avengers now have 2 hammers, because Iron Man has 1 and Vision still has 1. And Hulk has 1 and Thor has 1. So that actually means that the points are all even as we go into battle round 3, with the Asgardians going first. Both sides are on 7. So the first activation for the turn was Hulk, and he had a busy turn. He moved small to position himself in a nice little line of the Avengers there, then did a thunderclap for 3 power. Captain America took 2 from that, Black Panther took none, Iron Man took 3 but it got reduced to 2. So then he spent another 2 power on picking up Captain America and throwing him at Black Panther because he's trying for the knockout on Black Panther. So all said and done, Captain America took 3 damage in total. However, Black Panther also rolled very well in his evade roll and took no damage from that either. So Hulk has ended his turn there, he is within 2 of the middle shelter, he is a problem, and that stung a little bit. So Iron Man activated and played Ricochet Blast with Captain America, which we've seen before. So if it's Iron Man's activation and he's within 4 of Captain America, they may each spend 2, although he had to spend 3 because he's holding on to one of the hammers. And then you measure line of sight and etc. from Captain America 4. So he shot it at Loki. Loki spent 2 on I Am A God, so he could count blanks in his defense roll to try and protect against it. Unfortunately for him, 2 damage still got through and he only had 1 health left. So he is dazed and will not be getting an activation this turn. And, oh, did he have a hammer? No, I don't think he did. No, it's fine. He did not have a hammer. For Iron Man's other activation, he just tried to do a repulsor blast on Hulk to try and shove him off of the point and failed. But good use of that card there, I think. They're obviously still bunched together, which is a bad thing. But now it can only be Valkyrie or Thor. Thor activated and moved up medium to where you can see him kind of teetering on the edge of the crater there. Then he just did a basic strike on Iron Man, it did 1 damage and that was enough to daze him. Iron Man dropped the hammer he was holding, Thor has paid 1 power to pick it up, so he's got a hammer in each hand now, and is a lot more dangerous. He's also within 2 of the shelter too, so that means what, there's 2 healthy characters for each side there now. Okay, over to the Avengers. So Vision was the next to activate, but just to cover something I forgot to mention when we were covering Hulk's turn when he did the thunderclap, Captain America spent power to do Vibranium Shield to help protect himself from damage. It would normally go down to 1 thanks to day like any other, however he was within 4 of Loki, so it went right back up to 2. But just to keep it right how much power he has on him, he did use that. So anyway, Vision did nothing, he just moved twice to capture the back shelter there, which is pretty important actually. And that's it. So now Valkyrie has to go, and then Winter Soldier, Captain America, and Black Panther all get to just do whatever they want at the end of the turn. So for Valkyrie's turn, she stayed exactly where she was because she is barely within 2 of that shelter there. spent a total of 6 power on 2 Dragon Fang attacks, one of which generated a free strike attack. All said and done, she only did 3 damage. That was 2-1. She did not do well, and Winter Soldier did do well with his defense rolls. They do proc a bleed, though. So he's got 3 damage on him. He has 2 left, plus the bleed effect. And obviously Valkyrie is still there. However, he's still on his healthy side, so he's actually still claiming that. So now, Bucky, Captain America, and Black Panther get to do their actions, thanks to Loki missing his turn. So as things often go, the biggest amount of fighting was done in the middle of the map, but we can cover the last 3 activations. It was pretty simple. Black Panther just repositioned slightly and did a basic strike on Thor for no damage. Captain America threw his shield at Thor and Valkyrie. The one at Valkyrie missed, the one that hit Thor did 2 damage, which he just took to the face, probably literally. And then finally, the Winter Soldier spent 4 power on, what is it called, Red Fury. So he gets to do a pretty strong physical attack, followed by a push away small, and then an assault rifle attack. All said and done, Valkyrie took 4, and she did not have enough power to play Odin's Blessing to avoid it. So I think she's 1 away from death, or 2 tops, 1 or 2. And that takes us right to the end of Battle Round 3, into the cleanup phase. So as we went through the cleanup phase, we realised there was a unintended consequence of using Red Fury on Valkyrie because of the free push it includes. She was pushed out of safety of both those shelters, so I mean she's taken 1 damage as a result. She had 1 HP left, so Valkyrie has actually died in the cleanup phase and is out of the combat. She is gone. So in terms of victory points, the Avengers hold their closest shelter for 1, they hold the furthest away one for 3, nobody holds the middle one because it's 2 healthy characters on each side, Captain America, Black Panther, Hulk, Thor, means it's contested so nobody scores that. Thor has 2 hammers for 2 victory points there, and Vision is still holding 1 hammer, I believe. Oh sorry, yes, and Hulk has 1 hammer as well. So it's actually still staying very close. It's 12 victory points to the Avengers and 11 to the Asgardians. They're a lady down, but they will be going first in Battle Round 4. Thor activated and did not move. He stayed where he was. First of all, he did a basic strike on Iron Man to try and kill him. Captain America spent 2 to do his bodyguard and take the hit instead. He took about 3 damage, but only needed 1 damage taken to actually daze himself. So he is dazed and will not be getting a turn. And that 1 extra power generated from the 1 damage gave Thor enough power to do God of Thunder, which is a big Nova around him for 2, and it caught Black Panther and Iron Man. Iron Man only took 1 damage. He rolled very well for his defense, as opposed to a poor assault roll, attack roll rather. Black Panther, he took a bunch of damage, but he only needed 1 to also get dazed. So that was a double daze from Thor's turn. Stood still though, that's it. Black Panther and Captain America get no activations. So Iron Man activated, and the first thing he did was play Field Dressing, which does not cost 1 more, because remember Thor stole the hammer he picked up. So he played Field Dressing, which we can look at here. A character within 2 of a dazed allied character may spend 4 to play this card. He was within 2 of Black Panther and Captain America, but he chose Black Panther. Remove the dazed token and 1 damage from the allied character. So Black Panther is back as being conscious. He's 1 hit away from being dazed again. Then for his other action, he did a repulsor blast on Thor. Did 4 damage, he only needed to do 2, so he actually did daze Thor. And both those hammers are actually going to need to be put down there as well. Iron Man has no power on him. Oh no, he does actually. He has 2 power. Never mind, Iron Man picked up both those hammers that Thor just dropped. Totally forgot about that. Loki activated next, and he burned through a lot of power to get stuff done. First of all, he played Doomed Prophecy on himself. So that is, at the start of an activation, spend 3 to play it. They lose the ability to defend against physical attacks, but whatever their physical defense was get added on to their own physical attacks. He unleashed his basic strike, because that's his only physical attack he has, on Vision, did 3 damage, only needed to do 1, stunned him, then spent a power to pick up the hammer that Vision was carrying, so that's on his card now, used an action to move out of range to try and protect himself from the people over here, but still holding that there. So just when you thought he wasn't getting an activation, he got healed by Field Dressing, of course, so Black Panther activated, he moved along over here to this shelter where you can see him. Then he did a kinetic burst for 3 power on Loki, hoping for the push but didn't get it. Did however manage to do 2 damage, all said and done. Loki did use I Am A God for 2, so he counted blanks in his defense roll. And Vision is not counted as being there because he's dazed, so the explosion didn't affect him. So now it's the Hulk to end the Asgardian's turn, and then Bucky for the Avengers. So the Hulk's turn was always going to be dangerous, and indeed it was. He activated, he moved up small, he did a basic strike on Iron Man, It did 5 damage. Invincible Iron Man makes it 4. That is still enough to remove him, as I accidentally knock Thor over. So Iron Man has been removed. He dropped 2 hammers. Hulk has spent 2 power to pick them up. So Hulk is now holding 3 hammers, and they are basically safe as houses. On that note as well, it's just Winter Soldier to go. He's not going to shoot at Thor, because Thor is dazed, so he isn't currently on the table. He's not going to shoot at Hulk, because it's going to make Hulk even stronger. So he's just camping that shelter. And that takes us to the cleanup for Battle Round 4. So once again, the end of the match has actually just crept up and appeared. Did not realise, but Hulk swung that one for the Asgardians. If we look at the points for the shelter, the Avengers have their own one for 1. Hulk has the middle one for the Asgardians for 2, and then that one over there is a draw. However, Loki didn't get knocked down, and he's holding 1 hammer that he stole from Vision when Vision went down, and Hulk is of course holding 3 for 4 victory points, taking the score to 17 to the Asgardians and 13 to the Avengers. It's an Asgardian win. So I feel like the best matches of Crisis Protocol you have are the ones where you don't realise, like, a turn ahead of time, there's basically no way to stop the win happening. If Hulk hadn't had such an amazing turn there taking out Iron Man, they would have still been close. They would have been 2 away from winning, but there still would have been a chance. At the end of turn 3, going into turn 4, it looked like the Avengers had it when Valkyrie went down. It looked like they had it easy. But in these kind of things where you have an objective that needs to be held, Hulk is just so good at being the guy to hold the thing, because you don't want to hit him. Especially when it's hammers that are already making him stronger. If he did his Hulk smash is what, 8 dice? And then 9, 10, he would be at 11 for the number of hammers. If he had one more damage on him, that'd be 12. It's ridiculous. This mission was made for the Hulk, and anyone with Hulk-esque rules. That was fun, as I always end up saying. The Winter Soldier didn't really get much of a showing because he was just kind of hiding at the back, capping an objective. He's only 3 threats, so I feel like that's a fair thing for him to do. Vision was okay, got to get in the habit of declaring which phase form he's in if he gets used. It was a shame he went down at the end there. Loki made sure of it happening though with the doomed prophecy, etc. But, oh yeah, that's another thing. I wonder if it would have been better for Black Panther just to do a basic strike rather than a kinetic burst, because Loki wouldn't have been able to roll any defense dice thanks to doomed prophecy. The things you notice. I think there was a turn early on as well where Valkyrie technically could have played Odin's Blessing to reduce some of the damage she took, not the hit that killed her. Because she didn't have enough power then, but a hit before that she took was pretty bad, and that could have been played, I think. You know, it's a thing, you miss things as you play. Tactics that you look back on and were like, oh, should have done that. But that takes us to the end of this battle report. I sincerely hope you enjoyed watching it. There will be more to come in the future. The Guardians of the Galaxy are right around the corner, for instance. Expect to start seeing content on them very soon. Thank you for watching, and until next time, ta for now.